Get ready to match the stars from Dallas, Steve Kanaly. Red Summer. Charles Nelson Reilly. Elaine Joyce. From One in a Million, Richard Paul. And Patty Duke Astin. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rayburn.
Already out there? Are you ready up here?
No, ready.
Okay. Lois, would you step down here, please? And take your place on the little blue dot there. And we'll see if you're going to win a great big amount of money. Is Lois
Yamakoshi?
She won the game, her second one. And we're going to start with this big audience match here. Just see how she does. You ready?
Right.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Don't blow it this time.
Okay. Try not to.
Now pay attention this time, Lois.
We polled the studio audience.
Yamakoshi.
We said, please write down what you think would be the most popular answer to this. Blank made $500 for matching the most popular, $250 for matching the second most popular, and $100 if you match a third. Now you can call on three of our six stars. Whom do you want?
Charles.
I say, because I have a beautiful farm, I say...
Hold it back to that.
Homemade.
Homemade, yes.
All our jams, I want to say...
Steve?
All our jams and jellies are homemade at the ranch.
Yes.
A few people are asking.
Well, yes, but this is the 20th century, and most things that we see today are man-made.
Oh, man-made. I have a better one.
Got a lot of man-made at the ranch.
Oh, I do, too. Richard?
Handmade.
Very good.
Handmade. Handmade. All right. You have homemade, handmade, and man-made. Do you want one of those or one of your own choosing?
I'd like to try homemade.
Homemade?
Good idea.
No, that's Charles' answer is homemade. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. May we see the $100 number. Man-made is one they gave you. All right, I think you got a better shot at it this time.
Sure.
Let's take a look
do.
At the $250 response.
Handmade.
Well, that's two of the three they've given you. Last chance for homemade. Here we go. You've got it. Congratulations.
Very good.
All right. Now, Lois, you've won $500, but you can win a lot more now. Means the least you'll play for is $5,000, but we want you to spin the wheel and see if you can double it up and play for $10,000. Step right up there and have a go at it. And we'll all root for a double for Lois. Here we go.
Spin a big double now. That's it.
Come on, baby. Make
it a double. Let's do it right this time.
Gonna be you, Richard.
Let's do it right
there. Just slid by Richard, and that's hard to do. Step right down there, man. And good luck to you. Here we go for $5,000. Blank, Minnesota. Blank, Minnesota. All right, now if you give us the answer that Richard has on the card, you get $5,000. What do you say to that?
St. Paul.
That's what I wrote down before.
All right. Eight people agree with you. Richard, she says St. Paul, Minnesota will match
I almost hyphenated it because it's the same town, really. It's Minneapolis.
Minneapolis.
Boy, it is.
Well, now you see, in this, when we go for the big money, it has to be an exact match. I think even if you said Minneapolis, St. Paul, and if she just said St. Paul, it would not have been an exact match. And
it
wasn't
Boise, huh?
Boise, Minnesota, right. Very good.
That's in Connecticut.
The $500 is yours.
Thank you very
Thank you for being on the Match Game, Lois.
Thank you,
Yamakoshi. Welcome. Drew Gaines and Judy Kovac. Hello there. Welcome to the two of you. Two games for each of you. Now, we're going to ask these people to talk about themselves a little bit. But in case Drew Gaines looks familiar to any of our stars, she was here before, not too long ago. And we got involved in an icicle, an iceberg question.
Hooray.
And just as in football, the referees and umpires have to occasionally make a judgmental call, and occasionally they are wrong, not very often. Our judge occasionally has to make a judgmental call, and very often he is wrong. No, very seldom is he wrong, but he was wrong then, and in all fairness, he said, let's bring her back and give another shot at it. Yes?
There's people I know who want copies of that speech, so they should have a post office.
Send $1 to Match Game.
Colonel, what was his name, John McCormick? What, Colonel Robert R. McCormick?
Yes, and we will send you a mimeographed copy of that speech. Now, Drew, would you refresh our memories and tell us where you're from and how many children you have and all that? I remember you're married for a year and a half.
I've been at home for a year and a half. I've been married for over 3 years. I live in La Cañada. I'm a former store manager, and I'm happy to be here again.
Okay, Drew. And Judy Kovac, we're meeting you for the first time. Welcome, and tell us about yourself, please.
Well, I'm from Central City, Pennsylvania. It's a small town near Johnstown. I'm sure you've all heard of Johnstown.
Yes, indeed. That's a beautiful part of that state.
Yes. And I'm a retired school teacher, and my husband and I are out here visiting my daughter, who lives in Glendale.
All right. Good luck to both of you ladies. Let's begin with Drew. A or B?
B, please.
B for Drew Gaines. Wayne said, whoever said all men are created equal never saw Wilt Chamberlain standing next to blank.
You!
Isn't that a good one?
I like that. Now, those are good ones, and that's what we should have on here all the time.
All right, Drew. Wayne said, whoever said all men are created equal never saw Wilt Chamberlain standing next to blank.
Billy Barty.
Billy Barty.
Yes, sir.
Remember, she's the girl, the hip one, who really knows the answers.
Yeah, I wanted to say Charlene Tilton, but I couldn't do that because Charlene would get mad at me. So I said Paul Williams.
Paul Williams.
Paul, don't get mad at me.
Paul Williams comes to right about right here. There's Paul. Hello, Paul. How are you? Yes.
I said someone who's near and dear to my heart, and I'm crazy about, and as cute as a button, and you may wonder why I have on this funny blouse over this sweater.
Yes.
I'm overdressing because it's so bloody cold in this bloody studio. I'm nearly frozen to death, but I did say Paul Williams.
Also.
That's two of those. We're looking for Billy Barty.
Well, he's a friend of mine, and actually to use his name like that is not the nicest thing
in
the world.
He is short, though.
I know, but you can go in a fictionalized area.
Okay.
You know what
you
I mean?
You say me, I'm going to kill you.
A person. Paul Williams.
It is a fiction. Well, Drew, you see, you give a real clever answer like Billy Barty.
I love that.
Who is shorter than Paul Williams, and what do you get? Nothing. That's what you get. Nothing.
And I said Mickey Rooney.
Another short person.
But a fabulous person.
Yes.
I went shorter and younger. Gary Coleman.
Gary Coleman. One Billy Barty.
I can see that
a prejudiced
answer.
I always write Billy Barty, and this time I didn't. I wrote Hervé Villechaize.
The game.
Well, sorry about that. Love your answer. Well, you stand by for your first round question, but first this message for you. Here we go. I can't do that. Here we go. Because you can't use our button. All right. Judy, here it is. Ready.
You know your problem is you're too uptight.
Yes.
You've got to loosen up, hon.
Kevin said, my new girlfriend has hair down to her waist.
Whoops.
Unfortunately, it starts at her blank. Everybody ready?
Judy, charming.
Kevin said my new girlfriend has hair down to her waist. Unfortunately, it starts at her blank.
Chin.
Chin is a good response. Chin is one of the two really good responses.
Yeah, it's very good. I cleaned mine up from what it was, and I just said armpits.
Armpits. That hasn't occurred to me.
You know, sweetheart, I'd never go for that
answer.
Kind of trashy answer.
Now, this has got... Stop that coughing. I'm trying to conduct a show here. Now...
Yeah, that's what she thinks, too. She thinks it's her show. I'm trying to conduct a show here. She lives in this dream world.
What time does this show get to Chicago?
This has got to be it. Now, this has got to be a match. I don't want any arguments. I said jawline, which is your chin. Which is
jawline.
Your...
That sounds good.
That's one? Yeah,
got to be a match.
All right.
This is your jaw. Hi, Farmer Brown.
Chin is what we're at.
Why didn't she just write chin instead of jawline?
I don't know. She's devious. She's devious.
No, she's a deviant.
She has more chins than a Chinese phone book.
All right.
That's an old joke.
Two for Judy. Elaine?
I said lip, but it was pulled down to her chin. Is that all right?
No.
Those are real.
Which? The lips and the teeth?
The lips are real. Teeth involved.
Actually, the girl used to do children's theater.
Yes.
Played one of the Three Little Pigs and said to the big bad wolf, not by the hair of my chinny chin chin.
That's it. Ready for her.
Stories on the show.
Oh, I love it, Richard. I love it.
Yes.
Miss Patty?
I had nostrils, and then I went to something far worse.
Oh, well, that's three for her. We'll go to round two, and Judy, since you're ahead, you may go first.
A.
A for Judy. Don said it's tough being married to a practical joker.
How tough is it?
Today, she put Bengay in my tube of blank. Tough being married to a... You don't play, Brett. Neither do you, Charles. Neither does Richard. Judy, Don said it's tough being married to a practical joker. Today, she put Bengay in my tube of blank.
Toothpaste.
Toothpaste is what she said. What do you say, Steve?
Oh, when we were young, we used to do terrible things to each other and put Bengay everywhere. But I said toothpaste. That sounds terrible.
It burns, doesn't it? What do you say, Elaine?
I said toothpaste.
That's five for her now. Hello, Patty.
Go for it, Patty.
Moving right along. Drew, are you ready?
Ready.
All right.
Now you see why they didn't let her talk
in like
Miracle
me,
Worker?
Yes. Need five to tie, six to win. Have you heard about the Larry the Lush doll?
No.
Yeah. Here's what they... You wind it up and it blanks. You know what it is. Yeah. Drew game. Here we go. Have you heard about the Larry the Lush doll? You wind it up and it blanks.
Pours a drink?
Well,
bye, Drew.
You can't, every answer can't be brilliant, can it?
No.
Occasionally you have to be human. And you were human then.
She's trying to come
came
down
up with
to
a rotten
level.
Answer. Larry the Lush would do something else. See, he's not a bartender. A bartender would pour a drink. Larry the Lush would...
He's trying to make sense out of these cards.
You can answer and still get a match. You know, you drink some martini.
Drinks a martini.
Pours a drink. No?
No. Well, Larry the Lush drinks a martini. Now, you got to match everybody else to stay in the game, Drew.
Oh,
Brett?
I'm sorry. I said drinks a quart of vodka or sometimes of your martini and Manhattan
And that
variety.
Means Judy wins the game. What do the rest of you have?
Up jumps all over his dog.
Now, you'll be back later to play game number two. Okay?
Okay.
So we'll see you a little bit later, Drew Gaines. And now, right now, this message for you. Hurry back, see how much money Judy wins. Back is here. She will try for the big money now. You could win over $10,000 here. Good luck to you, my dear. Let's see what happens.
Go again,
we polled
Judy.
The studio audience, said write down your best answer to this. Adding blank. $500 for you if you match the most popular answer. $250 for matching the second most popular. And $100 for you if you match the third most popular answer. Three of the six stars are permitted to help. Whom do you want?
Brett.
Adding machine.
One.
Charles.
Adding and subtracting, which is a very big popular favorite. Thank you.
Patty?
Oh, this is terrible. I can't... Adding pounds?
What?
Adding pounds.
Pounds?
No. Adding pounds.
I'm very familiar with that.
Adding pounds, adding machine, and adding and subtracting are the three they've given you. Now you have the option of choosing one of their answers or giving us one of your own.
Don't take pounds.
Machine.
Yeah.
Machine is what you want.
Atta girl, please. Let's hope that's it.
All right. Let's take a look at the $100 response.
Yes. Adding on.
Adding on.
Oh,
I did that.
Oh, as in a room.
Adding on a room.
I added on a house to a house.
Yes, sir.
I'm just waiting for my bow.
Waiting for a bow?
Yes, when it comes up.
What is that? What?
Adding and subtracting that the audience laughed at when I said it.
Well, if I had some money, I would bet you a nickel or a dime.
You wouldn't have money. You don't have pockets in those Reuben Brothers suits.
Yes, I do. He thinks adding and subtracting is coming up now.
He's got a job.
Bob Barker.
Well, I could get a job opening those doors.
Yes, right. I'm sorry.
I've got the wardrobe.
Yeah, that's true.
And the legs, but you don't know that, do you?
No, I don't. And I don't want to find out about it.
Okay, I'm ready for my bow.
All right. May we see the $250 response? Oh! Thank you. You're clairvoyant.
You know, they should have made those with pockets.
You're going to win some money.
The nurse today yet?
No, I'll get the nurse for you.
Medications, Mr. Reilly.
The nurse will be here later now. Don't worry about it.
Medications, Mr. Reilly.
Judy is looking for the answer, adding machine.
And she's going to get it, too.
And we'll find out right now if adding machine is under the $500 response.
Yeah!
Yes, indeed it is. All right. The one that Brett gave you. Judy, you've got $500 cash, irrevocably yours. However, that means, you know, we multiply that by 10, and it means the least you'll play for is $5,000, but we want you to spin the star wheel. And if you get a lucky spin, you can double it and play for $10,000. Step up there, and good luck to you, and we'll all root for a double for Judy. Here we go.
Go, baby. Let's spin. Double it up.
What did you teach in school? Gambling one, gambling two?
Gambling three.
Yeah. All right. Good luck to you, Judy. Face
now
me if you would, please.
Try and get it right, Richard.
Here we go.
Richard,
this is it. First class blank.
Oh.
That's it. First class blank.
No. This. No.
No, all right.
I don't know. Any time this week will be sufficient, you know. We can wait till Sunday.
Okay, do that.
Okay.
What about this?
All right.
Oh, this was murder.
Now, if you give us the answer that Richard has on that card, a highly unlikely possibility... In view of the fact what he went through, but we'll hope for you here, Judy. You will get the $10,000. It's kind of a toughie, but see what you can do with it. First class.
Ticket.
First class ticket. What are you owing about?
Oh, I had the passenger who was holding the ticket.
You had passenger holding a first class ticket.
But my first answer here was mine, first class idiot.
Uh-huh.
That's what I feel like right now.
All right. Well, that was got a first-class passenger, first-class ticket, first-class fare. There are a number of good ones there. Now, Judy, you've got $500, and we're going to bring back Drew a little bit later. Right now, we want to do a little commercial for America, okay? Time to say goodbye, but before we do, I want to remind everybody to watch Steve Kanaly here on Dallas.
Kanaly. It rhymes with shillelagh, darling.
Shillelagh.
I wish I had a shillelagh. Or better still,
Kanaly.
Steve
Kanaly.
What
is the origin of that name?
I wish I had a little music called Kanaly.
Kanaly, it doesn't sound like an Irish name to me.
It doesn't.
The
Yes, get on with it.
Isn't he glib?
He is.
Now, that man made a signal to me that was obscene with his fingers.
The
Sarazine
is doing wonders. You're
just saying 20 seconds, that's all. He said 20 seconds.
Vincent Kanaly was a Weaver
Kanaly,
High School.
It rhymes with shillelagh. Now, I'm not going to tell you again, Farmer Brown.
What about this one? One in a million.
He was the wonderful class president, and he was the head of the football team.
All right. Kanaly.
Yes.
The women's room.
It's not where I have to go.
That man is doing that again.
It's time to say goodbye.
He is making a gesture that I find very unlikely.
Nurse, please come get Mr. Reilly.
Forever. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
Today's consolation prizes are Polyglyco sound shield for the noisy underside of your car, not an undercoating. Polyglyco is a sound shield at new car dealers only. And American Tourist, a strong, lightweight luggage, good-looking protection to keep your clothes looking good. American Tourist is the only way to travel. And a cosmetic tote bag and Chapstick lip balm, serious medicine to help heal and protect lips from sun, wind, and cold. Keep your lips smooth and soft with Chapstick lip balm. And a planter stand and Guardsman polish used by fine furniture manufacturers, rich in natural and organic oils, no silicones or wax buildup. And a carry-all and Buff Puff, the gentle cleansing sponge to smooth and soften your skin and let the younger you shine through. Beautiful skin begins with Buff Puff. And a manicure set and perfect nails for beautiful nails. House-hardened service coating gives nails protection from splitting and polish from chipping, furnished by Perfect Nail. And a lap blanket and Tri-Mimic. Have a cold, runny nose all stuffed up. Doctors say try Tri-Mimic syrup more than any other non-prescription cold remedy. Pleasant tasting and it works. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Totman production. This program was edited for broadcast.